Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Snigdha Bharadwaj, Assistant Professor, ITS College of Pharmacy. So, in this session we are going to discuss about general consideration about the production of enzymes. So, let us get started. So, first, what are the enzymes? Enzymes are macromolecular biological catalysts. We know enzymes very well, we have been studying since class 8th, right, enzymes. So, basically enzymes are macromolecular biological catalysts. Enzymes accelerate or catalyze or improve or increase the rate of reaction in particular chemical process. So, the molecules at the beginning of the processes are called substrate, right. If once we use substrates like A plus B, so we use enzyme here and we get C product. So, enzyme we are using here to increase the rate of reaction to get the maximum amount of the compound end product, right. The molecules at the beginning of the process are called substrate and the enzyme converts these substrate in different molecules called products, right. So, C is your product, A and B is your substrate, are substrates. Microbial enzymes are the biological catalysts for the biochemical reaction leading to microbial growth and respiration as well as the formation of fermentation products, right. So, microbial enzymes, the enzymes procured or collected from microbes are the biological catalyst we use specifically talking about chemical reactions, in microbial reactions or we can say biological reactions. Right. So, these are biochemical, the catalyst for biochemical reactions, like in fermentation processes we use these type of enzymes to increase the productivity of compound, formation of fermentation product. So, this is the protein structure or enzymes we can say. So, these are the blue site is your binding site and red dark site is your catalytic site. So, protein have both the functions, catalysis as well as binding site. So, here this is how a protein looks like, it is a cartoon representation, solid surface. So, types of enzymes, adaptive and constitutive. So, first adaptive type, produced only when the need arises, okay, produced. That means, we are producing particular type of enzyme once it is required. Example, when a cell is deficient of a particular nutrient. So, in that case to produce that particular nutrients, enzyme is required. So, we produce, body produce, itself produces, right. Constitutive, produce always is irrespective the amount of substrate. It is present all the time, right. Enzyme which are produced within the cell or at the cytoplasmic membrane are called endocellular, right. Within the cell or at cytoplasmic membrane is called endocellular enzymes. Enzymes which are liberated in the fermentation medium which can attack large polymeric substance as termed as exocellular enzyme. That means, if enzyme is present in within the cell is known as endocellular endotype, which is getting released in the fermentation process, exotype, right. So, this is how we categorize enzymes. Improved prospects of enzyme. So, for why we are using this enzyme as an important part of any process, like if we talk about food industry, if we talk about agriculture industry, if we talk about any type of biological processes, we give importance to these particular type of enzymes. Why? Microbial genetics. High yield can be obtained by genetic manipulation. So, in this particular subject, you must have heard about protein engineering, genetic engineering, right? Enzyme immobilization, enzyme application or productions. So, these all are important areas because enzymes are widely used for different purposes like agriculture, food industry and fermentation processes, chemical reactions. So, example, Hansmula polymorpha, it is a microbe has been genetically modified to increase 35% of its total protein with alcohol oxidase. So, this is how we increase the yield of particular enzyme for further usefulness. Optimization of fermentation conditions, like you know, variety of fermenters are used for producing different products in a better yield, right. In some processes, we use chemical reactions to produce different type of products, but we are here, we also uses fermentation processes for better yield, to get better yield of particular product, not preferable for chemical reactions. That means, we are using microbes or enzymes for that particular fermentation, like beer, alcohol, these all products are produced using fermentation very well, right. So, vinegars, all these things. Optimization for fermentation conditions, like if you are using an enzyme, so you first optimize or analyze what are the different conditions, or what are the pH, aeration, stirring temperature of the fermentation reactor. So, and at which condition your enzyme is stable or protein is stable if you are using it. So, cost of nutrients, optimal utilization of components and nutrient solution, temperature and pH. New cell breaking method like homogenizer, bead mill, sonication, these all are equipments we use for the fermentations. Modern purification process like counter current distribution, ion exchange chromatography, affinity chromatography, precipitation by alcohol and acetone. So, once fermentation is done, that means we need to separate out the product, because in their fermenter, in there all the components are mixed, right. So, we substrate is getting changed into a product, but how much product is there, also enzyme is also present. So, all these need to be separated and isolated from the enzymes. So, method of enzyme production is semi-solid culture. First, we use semi-solid, and then we can also have submerged type of cultures. So, semi-solid means you are using a semi-solid base onto which the enzyme is put or keep for few days, and the fermentation occurs, and then we can separate out the compound produced. So, in this, the enzyme producing culture is grown on a surface of a suitable semi-solid surface, moisture and wheat, or we can use different sources of nutrient mediums like moisture and wheat or rice bran with nutrients. Preparation of production medium, right. First, we need to prepare the nutrient medium, and then only we can put our semi-solid surfaced screen into that particular medium to grow the growth of that particular product. Bran is mixed with solution containing nutrient salts. So, pH is maintained at neutral level, medium is steamed, sterilized, right. So, these are the cofactors which needs to be maintained during the enzyme production. The sterilized medium is spread onto metal trays, right, culture. Once you set all these conditions like pH, temperature, aeration, stirring, nutrient medium, and at the right or optimum range, then you can expect the high yield of particular enzyme to grow in that particular ration. The sterilized medium, right, highly enzyme concentrate is a crude fermented material. So, that crude fermented material then separate out and purify it. Semi-solid cultures, like advantages, comparatively low investment, right. So, these semi-solid are very cheap and easy to access, allow the use of substrate with high dry matter content, cultivate those molds which cannot grow in fermenters due to wall growth, right. So, these type of those microbes or enzymes which cannot grow in other fermenter, we can use semi-solid fermentation process. Allows the mold to develop is in their natural state. So, there is no change in the physiological state of enzyme. So, we can expect the growth naturally of these particular molds we are using through semi-solid cultures. some disadvantages are also there. Requires more space and more labor, involves greater risk of infection, right? So, because some one process may have different pros and cons. So, some disadvantages are there, although we can overcome these disadvantages, but somehow labor is exposed to these type of disadvantages when working on semi-solid cultures. So, involves greater risk of infection to our labor, difficult to introduce automation in such system, these are manual type of systems, high cost. So, once in advantages it is written comparatively low investment, but if you talk about the overall process expenses, it is high. So, semi-solid cultures produces several enzymes, some of industries are growing some enzymes on using semi-solid cultures like alpha amylase using Aspergillus oryzae enzyme, gluco amylase, rhizopyrus species, lactase Aspergillus oryzae, pectinase Aspergillus niger, protease Aspergillus niger and Aspergillus oryzae, rennet mucor spulus, right. So, these are some examples. So, second type is submerged culture. So, submerged fermentation equipment's requirement, it is a cylindrical tank of stainless steel and it is equipped with an agitator, aeration device, a cooling system and various ancillary equipments, foam control, pH monitoring, temperature devices. So, you see you have seen in some books that this type of stainless steel tank, feed tube, aeration devices and all of that. It looks like that a tank which contains. So, it can be used as a batch fermenter or it once the devices are joined like this. So, these are known as continuous fermentation process. So, growth is good growth is not enough to obtain a higher enzyme yield, right. The presence of inhibitors or inducers should also be checked in the medium. Yes, during fermentation we cannot expect that all the time we are getting the high yield of enzymes. There are some cofactors like presence of any metal, presence of any component which might affect the growth of enzymes or function of enzymes. So, in this case we must know the effect of the cofactors we are getting during the process, and so we must ensure that if it is affecting negatively to the process, then we must eliminate those components from the process, right. So, example, presence of lactose induces the production of beta galactosidase. So, if you are producing one particular type of enzyme and due to presence of lactose it is promoting the other enzymes to grow. So, this is not required during the process. So, you must ensure before, so preliminary studies are important in that case. If you design some sort of fermentation process, then you should know the main factors and the cofactors of the process to grow a particular enzyme with particular sensitivity, particular functionality. As the inducers are expensive, so you use inducers, in some cases we use inducers to promote particular enzyme growth. Example, alternatively as the inducers are expensive, constitutive mutants are used which do not require an inducer. So, we use constitutive mutants. So, glucose represses the formation of some enzymes like alpha amylase, thus the glucose concentration is kept low, right. So, we know that if we are going to produce alpha amylase, then in that particular fermentation process glucose concentration will kept low. Certain surfactants, these are the method requirements, right. Certain surfactants in the production of medium increases the yield of certain enzymes. So, you should add surfactant if it is suitable for the production process. Non-ionic detergents like tweens, spans, tritons are frequently used. Advantages are less labor because easy automation is there and low risk of infection because it is hopefully fully covered. So, no exposure of the material to the labor. And disadvantage is high setup cost because it is all automatic. So, basically these are two types, submerged and semi-solids. Now, how once separation, once production is done, how you separated the enzyme? We need, one need to isolate the enzyme, right, from the fermentation process, from the fermentation tank or fermenter. Once fermentation is finished, the fermented liquor is subjected to rapid cooling to about 5 degree centigrade in order to reduce deterioration, because enzymes are degradable or can be denatured at higher temperatures. So, we immediately transfer those isolated fraction to the cooling temperature at 5 degree centigrade. Separation of microorganism is accomplished either by filtration or by centrifugation. From the medium, how one can separate the enzyme from the nutrient broth? So, either we use filtration process or we use centrifugation process to isolate the solid enzymes, and refrigerated and adjusted with pH adjustment, right. To obtain high purity of enzyme, it is precipitated with acetone. Precipitation is another way to isolate enzymes. Alcohol or inorganic salts or ammonium or sodium sulfate. In case of large scale operation, salts are preferred to solvent because of explosion hazard. So, these are different cases. We cannot say that one particular method is enough for one particular type of preparation, fermentation process. So, we have ample of procedures. One can find one method suitable and feasible for the production. So, first is amylases. So, in your syllabus, there are several 5-6 enzymes mentioned. So, how we produce these enzymes? So, we will go one by one. Amylases, a group of enzymes that hydrolyze complex sugar. What is the main use of amylases in industry? Because it hydrolyze the complex sugar into simple sugars. Like if you are looking for breaking down starch or sucrose into a glucose production. So, you can use these amylases enzymes in that particular production process. So, these are useful there. Complex sugars like starch, sucrose and glucose, fructose, simple sugars. Source of amylases, it can be produced by bacteria, fungi extracted from barley, beans and potato. Alpha amylases and beta amylases are of two types. Alpha amylase is found in animal kingdom and are designated as alpha amylase, whereas plant kingdom amylases are designated as beta amylases. So, amylases properties, it can be produced by Bacillus subtilis, Bacillus mesenteroids, right, and fungal amylases like Aspergillus niger, Aspergillus oryzae. So, bacterial and fungal, we have we are comparing both the types, right. So, more as bacterial type is more resistant and like up till 90% it is stable, whereas fungal is stable at up to 55 degree centigrade. So, liquefying enzyme depolymerizes starch of bacterial amylases. Liquefying enzyme hota hai, depolymerizes starch, produces rapid fill in the viscosity of dispersion, whereas a fungal amylases is sacrificing enzymes, produces reducing sugar such as maltose. So, where you need to produce maltose, then you will use fungal amylases. Dextrans, maltose, end product is dextran and maltose, and method of production is submerged culture, whereas fungal amylases can be used for semi-solid cultures. So, applications of amylases, alcohol industry, baked products, brewing, feed products, right, barley preparation and liquefaction of additives. So, here we use. Second is catalysis. Catalysis enzyme is an enzyme that converts hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. Now, you identifies the significance of making these type of enzymes for further production, where in chemical industry we need to convert hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, or in such reactions where we needed these type of enzymes to convert hydrogen peroxide to water and oxygen, then we use catalysis. The bacteria that contains this enzyme are usually aerobic, need oxygen, or facultative anaerobes, can live with or without oxygen, right. So, the catalase test is used to detect the presence of enzyme catalase in bacteria. Purpose: identification for gram positive and gram negative organism. It is a primary test used in differentiation of staphylococci and streptococci, right. So, basically catalase significance is it is converting hydrogen peroxide into oxygen and water. So, the test needs to be performed for identify or for detecting the presence of enzyme catalase in bacteria, because it is getting procured from the bacteria, anaerobic bacteria, or the bacteria which can live with or without oxygen. So, first catalase test to be performed on these type of bacteria before producing. So, primary test streptococci and staphylococci are different type of bacteria. So, primary tests are put on these type of bacteria, and also valuable in differentiating aerobic and anaerobic bacteria. Definitely, it cannot be present in anaerobic. So, one if it is detecting in any type of particular organism, we can say that it is aerobic. So, how it is done? Catalase test: place a small amount of bacterial colony, that means 18 to 24 hours old, and clean glass slide catalase colony. Add 1 to 2 drops of 3% of hydrogen peroxide. Inference: how you get the point that it is giving positive or negative results? If rapid bubble formation, that means it is converting hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, and negative bubble formation, that means no catalase present. So, it is how it is tested. Applications are: commercial catalase are also used to break down hydrogen peroxide in wastewater treatment. So, it is a big application. Catalase has various industrial application. In the food industry, it is used in combination with other enzymes in the preservation of foodstuffs. So, in preservation, we can also use this type of enzyme. Commercial catalase are also used to break down hydrogen peroxide in wastewater treatment. So, here it is repeated again. So, in food industry and in wastewater treatment, we use catalysis. So, once again, we just look at the highlights of the presentation. So, here we have discussed about basic introduction, biological catalyst, that is enzymes. These are the two sites, binding and catalytic sites of the enzymes, binding sites and catalytic. Catalytic site mainly used for increasing rate of reaction. Types: adaptive, constitutive, right, and constitutive, endocellular and exocellular. So, during fermentation, which type of enzyme participating, that means exocellular. So, the enzymes also used for improved microbial genetics and for commercial purposes. So, method of enzyme production are of two types: semi-solid culture and submerged culture. Submerged separation of enzyme can be done by transferring it into a by using filtration, centrifugation, precipitation, and salt addition. So, these are amylases, which is used to hydrolyze complex sugar into simple sugar like starch, sucrose into glucose, fructose, and these are basically used for food industries and different, and alpha and beta amylases. Alpha is bacterial amylases, beta is fungal amylases. Alpha amylases may be animal kingdom and beta is from plant kingdom. So, alpha amylases may be divided into bacterial and fungal, and catalysis used to convert hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. and the tests need to be performed to confirm the presence of catalyst, and these are references. I hope you liked my presentation and you understand the basic significance of these particular types of enzyme production and its industrial applications. Thank you. Stay safe. Take care.